Today, I want to talk about a very useful add-on for Blender users. This add-on allows you to easily convert a series of images into a page flipping animation. It is especially helpful for beginners as it significantly simplifies the complex animation process in Blender. Normally, creating a page flipping animation manually in Blender is both time-consuming and requires a certain level of experience. However, with this add-on, you can complete the process with just a single click. Before we start using the add-on, let's go step by step through how to install it in Blender and configure the basic settings. First, download the add-on file from its official source or the developer's website. I will leave a link in the description. Click on this link, press the I want this button, enter 0 in the price field, and then click the get button. On the next screen, press the download button to download the file to your computer. The files are usually in zip format. Start Blender on your computer and go to the Edit menu in Blender's main interface. Then select Preferences. In the window that opens, click on the Add-ons tab. Next, select the zip file you downloaded and click the Install from Disk button. If the add-on doesn't appear as enabled, you need to manually check the activation box to enable it. If you have many add-ons installed, you can use the search bar to find it quickly. Before using the add-on, we need to properly prepare our image files. This add-on works with image files that are named sequentially in a specific folder. Therefore, after collecting your images in a folder, it is important to name the files in order. For example, you can name your images 1.png, 2.png, 3.png, and so on. If the images are not in the correct order, your animation might look disorganized and you may not achieve the desired effect. Make sure the files are named correctly. It is also important that the file format is PNG or JPEG. Now we can return to Blender and start creating our page flipping animations. First, delete the default objects in the scene. Under Object, you will see 5mm Blender, and under that, there is an option called Flip my page. This is where we can access the add-on and use it to create page flipping animations. As you can see, the add-on is not very complicated. First, we need to set the width and height of the page. I set the width to 7 and the height to 10. This defines the aspect ratio. You can adjust these dimensions according to your images. These settings directly affect the appearance of your animation. So, make sure to choose the right size based on your project needs. In fact, let's enter the exact dimensions of the image here. The next step is to set the number of pages. To determine how many pages your flipbook will have, use the number of pages field. Here, you need to enter the number of pages you want to include in the animation. However, in the free version, the limit is 10 pages. If you need more, you will have to upgrade to the full version. While this limitation is sufficient for simple projects, for more extensive work, the full version might be worth considering. Since I have 7 images, I enter 7 here. The time to flip setting controls the flow of the animation. This determines how fast the pages will flip. A higher value makes the animation slower, while a lower value creates a faster transition. The start frame setting determines when the animation will begin. For example, if you want it to start at frame 80, enter 80 here so that the page flip animation starts when the playback reads frame 80. With normal mode and video flipbook, you can choose whether the flipbook will use images or video. Since we are creating a page flipping animation with images, we will leave it on normal mode. In the page image folder section, select the folder where you stored your images. I will enter the path to my folder here, or you can browse and select it manually. Once all the settings are configured, click on the OK button to generate the animation. The add-on will automatically arrange the images in order and create the page flipping animation. Instead of entering the exact pixel values, it is better to input the aspect ratio. So, I change and adjust it to 7 to 10. When we click the OK button, it will generate a book-like animation. Now, let's play the animation to see how it looks. To visually test the animation, we can use the viewport playback feature by clicking the viewport shading button. This allows us to see the material applied to the pages. I moved the images slightly upward so that the grid below them isn't invisible. After setting up the flipbook, press the play button to review the animation. Click on it and let's take a closer look at how the system and animation work. As you can see, the images we added appear in order. Now that we have created the animation, you can make some adjustments. For example, if the pages overlap too much, you can slightly move them up to make them more visible. You can adjust the pages manually here. We can see page 1, page 2, up to page 7. Currently, page 1 is selected, which should be the first page. I move it up a little. Now, when I play the animation, there won't be any issues. By default, when the animation is generated, the pages may appear stacked on top of each other. You can fix this by adjusting the vertical positioning. For example, I move page 2 slightly higher. Once this page is set, page 1 will transition smoothly to page 2. As I move forward in the animation, you might notice some unnecessary pages in the background. If you don't want them, you can delete them since they are individual objects. Deleting them will leave only the necessary pages. With small adjustments like these, you can create a successful page flipping animation. Since I originally set it to 7 pages, the last page caused an issue, so I changed it to 8 pages. When I set it to 8, the unwanted background page is no longer visible. Now let's replay the animation and take one last look at how the page flipping effect turned out. As you can see, the free version of Flip My Page allows you to create basic page flipping animations. In the full version, additional features such as cover page customization and page thickness adjustments are available for more advanced control. That's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. See you in the next tutorial.